concepts, especially the software engineering concept, vital role in the OAE subject. It is not new to you. You are familiar with this. This subject handled by me and Shubha ma'am, Geeta Rani ma'am. So while I'm taking class, please take down the notes. I will give a PPT presentation. I will give notes at all, but at the instantly, you noted some valuable points, some real-time example. It is helpful to you to remember a lot at any time. So please go through my lecture. At the same time, you have to note down some valuable points. I clearly present a well-structured manner. It is helpful to organize the information at any time. So please carry on my notes. If you are having doubts, you can give some message to chat. At last, you can ask some questions also. Now I'm going to tell the OAD subject, especially the OAD subject focus on the five units, the unified process and use case diagram, static UML diagram, dynamic implementation UML diagram, design patterns and testing. You are saying, what is the UML? You look the syllabus. UML is a unified modeling language. That language having some lot of notations and components are there. There are several different, total 9 different types of UML diagrams are there. Based on the 9 diagrams, we are having the lab also. We can do the, with the help of the Argo UML. No problem. I will tell in the fifth or sixth class, I will tell how to draw the diagram. No, nothing to worry. So UML is a unified modeling language. Based on the UML, we are drawing the some scenarios. Now we come to the first top. Now we come to the first, what our content is there in the unit one. That is the OAD object oriented analysis and design, that is the unified process, UML diagram, the use case case study followed by the generation post system, use case modeling, relating use cases, include extent generalization, when to use a use case. UML, don't forget, unified modeling language. At any instant, I'll ask, you are immediately at a single millisecond can say unified modeling language, UML, does play a vital role in the OAD. Now, before that, that is the object here, while you come to the software engineering, you're studying the life cycle, analyze, first thing, what are the 5 phases? Analysis, design, implementation, coding, and then result. Especially that is a year also.
Sir, you are not audible. My sir's voice audible, please. Anyone tell in chat?
No, ma'am. Sir's voice is not audible, ma'am.
Ah, yes, ma'am. I try to recover it soon. Geeta Rani, ma'am, please make a call to Pradeep, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Wait for a second.
So, in the meantime, I will continue. As sir said, this OOAD, this is a short form for object-oriented analysis and design. We all know that analysis is a very important part before getting into anything. Suppose we all have the dream to construct a house. We all have some dream house in our mind. For that dream house, we were planning from our childhood, from our college days itself. Yes? So our house should look like this. It should be a villa. It should have some swimming pool like that. So that is the planning. That is the very prerequisite. That is the very important thing we are doing for any step, for any action. After planning, what we have to do, how much amount we have to collect, how much money we have to save to build the particular house like that. So that is the analysis part. For that analysis, we have to gather some requirements. So we can call it as requirements gathering or requirements analysis. Any one of you, if sir has joined, please tell me. Sir will continue. After planning, we have to do proper analysis. For that, we have to make some requirements gathering. Pradeep, sir. Okay. So analysis part is most important. After analyzing, what we have to do means we are making some design. We will build a dream model. We will build a rough model in thermocol, or we can draw it in our paper itself, or we will use some software to design our model house. So that is the design part. Yes. Then the implementation is the actual construction of the house, where the hall should be, how it looked like, where the portico should be, like that, we'll have some plan. So we are going to implement it actually. Then we are testing. I think sir is moving on with the slides. So then we are testing whether all are in the proper place like that. That is the testing and debugging. And here, for actual construction, debugging means some flaws may occur and due to carpenter work or plumbing work like that. So that debugging we are going to do, then we are finally entering into the house. So this is the actual scenario. So we have to apply these steps. We can apply these steps to any software problem. That thing only we are going to discuss in this entire subject, object oriented analysis and design. So we can continue with this. So analysis has to be done before the design. What is analysis? What is design? Can anyone tell it in short phrase? What do you mean by analysis? Analysis means what we are going to do. Yes? How we are going to do is the implementation. That is the major difference. As in the slide, analysis, it mainly focus on the investigation of the problem and requirements rather than the solution. We are not at all bothering about the solution. We are going to focus on the problem and its requirements. As I told earlier, we have to look at the requirements only. Pradeep sir, Geetharani ma'am, did you call sir?
Ma'am, I called and informed him regarding the issue.
Okay, but
I think he has muted his session. I think so.
No,
it
but
it's not audible.
He is running the slides. He is presenting.
No,
sir is present.
Let me call him once again, ma'am.
Call and tell. He is running the slides only. His voice is not audible. Once if he comes, means I will stop. He can continue.
Okay,
so these are the steps with respect to analysis. First, you have to analyze the problem, main problem. Then you have to describe the process for analyzing that particular problem. What are the objects to be identified? That is the third step. Then specify the attributes. That it means characteristics. What are the attributes for the particular object? What are the needed attributes? So you have to specify those attributes. Then define the operations. Using those attributes and object, what operations we are going to do. And finally, you are going to establish the inter-object communication. Yes, so these are the important steps in analysis, especially with respect to object-oriented analysis, because we are going to focus on objects. What we are going to do with respect to objects. Objects play the major role here. So we are not simply calling it as analysis. It is specifically called as object-oriented analysis. Got it? As I told earlier, this OOAD, it is characterized by three important features: class, its state, and its behavior. So we are going to implement all these steps using UML diagrams. This is the fundamental for OOAD subject. These are the important things you have to understand for the OOAD subject. So analysis, design. Before analysis, what is the important prerequisite? Planning. So we can call the planning and analysis as the first step. Planning, analysis, design, implementation, then testing and debugging, verification, like that. Okay, well, so all these things we are going to implement using the UML diagrams. UML stands for Unified Modeling Language. Unified. Sir, if sir go through the slide, we can cover. Okay, no problem. I'll continue with this. Unified Modeling Language. It is not a scripting language. It is not a programming language. It is a modeling language. So which phase we are going to concentrate here? As the name itself implies, can anyone unmute and tell? In this unified modeling language, which phase we are going to concentrate on? Yes, students, shall I pick up some name and ask? B. Kirtana, unmute your mic and tell the answer.
Ma'am?
B. Kirtana, this unified modeling language focus on which phase?
Designing, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Though it is right or not, try to answer. Yes, design phase. Because we are going to design using some model. We are going to create some model. That model we are going to create using some software tool. For implementing that tool, we are using the language called Unified Modeling Language. Got it? Okay. I will share the screen now for time being. Pradeep sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Will you continue? Is it okay for you now, sir? Sir, shall I continue or you present the screen? Okay, time is running up. I will continue. I think these slides, sir, has covered. So we can create different models to show the static structure, behavior, dynamic behavior, and the deployment. Deployment means how we are going to actually release the code, how we are going to implement the code and release it to be used for the end users. So all these things we are going to represent using language called Unified Modeling Language. So this OOAD stands for object oriented, objects and communication. How the objects are going to communicate. For that we are having two important concepts, inheritance and encapsulation. And apart from that, classification is also there. So first in the diagram you can see we are going to do requirement analysis. After that we are look it into the real world objects, because in that real world object you will have different domains, different problem domains. So we are going for that particular problem domain. We have chosen what design we are going to do, how we are going to achieve the solution. For that you are going to identify some objects. It may be interface, application objects, utility objects, like that. Yes. So these things has covered. Okay. With this I stop. So these are the activities for analysis phase: analyzing the problem, describing, identifying the objects. For any object, its attribute is important, because through those attributes only we are going to define the operations. We can simply call ourselves as an object. We, student or staff, we can be called as an object. What are the characteristics for identifying you? Your roll number, name, date of birth, marks, etc. Yes, using those things, what can we do? Some operations we are going to do. Using your marks, we are calculating GPA of first sum. Using the second sum marks, we are calculating the GPA of second sum. Like that, based on that, you are calculating the CGPA. This can be called as the operation. Okay. Now this is the design phase. This phase only we are going to majorly concentrate. But analysis also we are going to do, because we can't directly enter into the design phase. So it tells about the conceptual solution that fulfills the requirements rather than the implementation, because the actual implementation will be carried out later only. How we are going to look at into the solution, that will be taken care later. Okay, how you are going to fulfill the requirements, what solution we are going to do. So that is specified here as conceptual solution, both in terms of software and hardware. So that is determined by the design phase. Example for design, the database schema. Schema means structure, how it is designed. A table like structure, you are having some rows, columns like that. So the description of a database schema can be called as the design. Yes, normally the designs, after completing the successful design, we can go for implementation. So in OOAD, we are specifically calling it as OOD. OOD stands for object oriented design. It involves the understanding of the domain. Now, how we are going to build the object model, how we are going to identify the objects, all these things are discussed in the object oriented design. So hope you are clear with object oriented analysis and object oriented design. So this is the aim of object oriented analysis: the model that is developed which describes the software as it works as a to satisfy the set of customer defined requirements. That is the purpose of OOA. OOD, just I have mentioned here. So this combination is the object oriented analysis and design, because previously many researchers, they have focused only on object oriented analysis. Few researchers, they focused only on object oriented design. Later only all those persons, they have formed together, they have united together, and they commonly formed that unified modeling language. So for object oriented analysis and design also. So you can look at the diagram here. There is a book. So we identify that object. So book is a object. So that is called as your visualization. How I am going to visualize the particular object? For that book, what, how you identify that it is a book? It will have some title, title of the book, author. It will have some 100 pages like that, some index like that. It has some different chapters and all. Okay, so we are identifying the book using attribute called what? Title. That is mentioned in the next line, that is below that book. You can look at the diagram. There is a symbol. After that, you are having that book. Below that book, you have to mention the attributes. After listing all the attributes, you have to list the functions. That is called as class. This is a simple representation of a class. This we are commonly using in any object-oriented programming language, in C++ or Java. Yes, public, class, student, or class student, open braces, int roll number, char name of 10, like that we are writing. Those are the data members. Yes, same thing only we are going to represent it visually. A visual representation of any class that can be done through the unified modeling language. It will be very interesting. It's not like there is nothing that to worry about code and all. We are going to do only design part. We are going to draw different kinds of diagrams. For those diagrams, we have to remember some notations. So this rectangular box, this book, it is the name of the class. Below that, you are having the title. That is the attribute for that particular class. Based on that, what can we do? We can use the in the code part. You can see public chapter, get chapter of. So I can use some function to get the chapters or to get a particular chapter. For that, I am going to use some function. So this is the major thing. This is the fundamental thing we have to remember. So here, a book is an object, software object. It has some title as an attribute and get chapter as a method or function. Like this, you have to draw for all the objects. First, you have to identify the objects for your particular domain, for the statement in your domain. Then you have to write the attributes and functions. Yes. This is the difference between design and analysis and design. A very important slide. Object-oriented analysis, it will identify the objects. It will identify the classes. But the design, it will decide how to implement. Yes, that is the difference. Who am I or what I can do? All those things are represented using the classes. But design part, what will do? How you decide how to implement those classes, how you are going to represent the behavior, etc. Yes, what we are doing, that is analysis. How we are doing, that is the design part. In simple words, you can remember. In the bottom of the slide, you can see classes can be designed. That is objects. We are going to model different objects. For attributes, its corresponding design model is data structure. What data structures you are going to identify. In analysis model, we call it as methods. In design model, we can write different algorithms to implement that particular method. Here we call it as relationship. There we are going to see it as messaging. How we are going to communicate, how the objects are communicating with one another. There is one important concept in OOPs with respect to communication. Can anyone unmute and tell fast? There is one important object-oriented programming concept with respect to communication. Students, anyone unmute? Last concept in object-oriented programming. You remember? You can put it in chat also. Charumita. GUI, no, it's not GUI versioning. Charumita, A section. Joshua, no. Not that much complicated, I'm asking. I'm simply asking the OOPs concept, last OOPs concept. There are seven major OOPs concepts. No, encapsulation is not there. I told the clue also. It's not inheritance, Anshul. Okay, let's see one by one. What are the, so you are telling all other concepts. Abstraction is wrong versioning. Anybody else? So we have different OOPs. We have major concepts in OOPs. Object, class, yes. First, we can tell it in order. Objects, classes, data encapsulation, and abstraction. Third one, inheritance. Polymorphism, yes, Kishore Kumar said it a little bit right. Information passing, it's not information passing, it's message passing. same meaning only, but here as told we are going to concentrate on messages, how object communicate with each other, message passing, and your last concept is dynamic binding. Don't forget these concepts. These are the ABCD of object oriented programming. Yes, so that's message passing we are going to do in our OOAD through UML diagrams. Got it? Are you able to see the screen, Pradeep sir?
It's visible, ma'am.
Okay, sir. But you, it's saying you are presenting. I am presenting the screen.
Okay, okay.
You please stop the presentation, sir. Okay. I'll continue. Okay, so now we are going to see a very important fundamental concept with respect to OOAD, that is called as unified process. As I told, we are going to use a diagram called unified modeling language. Unified means the combined approaches of all the researchers who have focused on analysis, design, both the things. Okay, because there are some focused only on analysis, some focused only on design. So to combinedly execute all these things, we are using a term called unified process. A unified process, it is a iterative process and it is an incremental software development process. You might have studied so many models in software engineering, waterfall model, spiral model, etc. Okay, so like that, an extra benefited model is the unified software development process. Here you are going to use the iterative method and it is an incremental software development. We can do repeated iterations to get the correct output, and also the output of one phase can be given as input to the next phase. It's an incremental model. It is generally used to describe the generic process. There is one term, another term called RUP, but we, in this introduction class, we will stop with this unified process itself. Okay, there is one more thing called rational unified process. It's a rigorous, it's a little bit complex one for many, many other domains. Normally this unified process, it will describe the generic process. So this unified process was published in the year 1999 by these three scientists, as I told already, Ivar Jacobson, Grady Booch, and James Rumbaugh. Better you remember those last names. UML means these three persons should come in your mind. Jacobson, Booch, and then Rumbaugh methodology. As told earlier, there were different methodologies that were used before the unified process. Jacobson method, Booch method, Rumbaugh method, because they concentrated only on design or only on analysis. Later only they combined and they formed this unified software development process by all these three scientists. These researchers, they played a key role in developing this unified process and the UML language. It's the major process for building the object-oriented systems. Yes, the main goal of this unified process is to give the high quality software. That is the important thing. Because for any software, there may be some flaw, either in the analysis part or in the design part, or during implementation, we may face some issue. During testing also, they can face issue. After that, if they rectify, in another testing, there may be some other issue like that. We are crossing all those things in many softwares. So what's the ultimate aim of unified process means to enable the production of high quality software. that meet all the requirements of the users with some reasonable budget and with predictable schedules. That is called as unified process. So these are the different phases in unified process. Yeah, we will see it in detail in the next class. These are the four important phases. Yes, inception phase, elaboration phase, construction and transition phase. Okay, we will see these phases, function of all these phases in detail later. I'll move on to this syllabus part because you have to know the continuation of this thing. As sir told, in unit 1 we are going to focus only on the unified process and the use case diagram. There are many diagrams. We are going to see 8 main diagrams. In that, the first diagram name is called as use case diagram. I hope you have studied these things in software engineering. You might have implemented also. These things we are going to see in a different way, in an elaborated way, use case diagram. Second unit, it fully deals with all the static UML diagram. Third unit deals with the dynamic UML diagrams. And the fourth unit, design patterns. Very important and interesting one. What are the patterns that are used in the design part? We may have different patterns for our shirts, for our pants. We may have different patterns for any materials. So in our coding also, we have different design patterns that we will see in fourth unit. And finally, in the fifth unit, some testing tools that are used. Also, automation tools that are used. Okay. With this, we can stop. We will discuss the remaining things in the next class. And now, it's question answer session. I need some quick answers from few of you. Praveen Karthik, are you there? Unmute your mic. Praveen Karthik. My class is not yet over. Don't leave the meeting. Just it is question answer session for last 5 minutes. Praveen Karthik. Arun Balaji, are you there?
Please answer, Pa.
What are the different phases of SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle? Anybody else can also answer. Unmute and you can tell the answer. What are the different phases of SDLC? Just I have mentioned all those things only.